Crystal Lake, celebrating 25 years. Its beginnings were humble. A quarry for road fill to build I-75 and other projects prior to January 1989 when it was approved. It was described as a park for recreational vehicles on Collier County Route 951 outside of Naples, Florida, on the edge of the Everglades. Developers, the Wisman family of Landmark Management Company, envisioned a spacious, well-landscaped resort. I personally congratulate those who took the plunge and put down $500 to reserve a lot on a project when viewed from the outside looked dubious at best. If the buyer was not pleased when he or she returned, they would receive their $500 plus 10% interest. I'm sure that some folks doubted that was going to happen, but others grabbed on for the ride. A great deal of land sculpting needed to be completed to merge two shallow lakes, and a tremendous amount of fill was needed to form the fingers or cul-de-sacs into the lake. Roads had to be built from scratch, areas opened. In the process, many native Floridian trees had to be preserved or replaced. This was especially true of the cypress tree. The project's first office was actually a GMC motorhome equipped with two card tables set out under the motorhome's awning. The office continued to expand into a double-wide mobile home containing the general manager's office and the sales department. 490 lots were committed to in the final plan. Standard lots were 40 feet by 80 feet, consisting of 20 by 60 concrete pads, sod, and 5-foot hookups, two queen palm trees, and a picnic table. In early stages of phase one, buyers saw nothing but the lake and large piles of rock and sand. Red flags were placed by the developer where each cul-de-sac was to be located, and potential buyers were only allowed to hike a few hundred yards as it was too dangerous to go any further. The first boat dock was minimal in nature, but later developed into our current boat dock setup. Sailboats, electric motor-powered smaller craft, and kayaks are moored there. The current dock and ramp is floating to accommodate the rise and fall of the water levels as much as 6 to 7 feet from late spring to early fall, the rainy season. More recently, a radio-controlled sailboat dock was added, but sometimes the high water mark in the fall after the summer rains restricts access, but only temporarily. The center of activity is the main attraction of Crystal Lake. Basically completed, refurbished, and modernized in the past 25 years, it truly represents one of the main reasons Crystal Lake is rated 10-10-10 by Camping World. This rating is only found in 62 resorts out of over 12,000 RV parks in North America. That is the top 0.5%. We are in Florida. Our visitors are many, some good, some not so good. The famous alligator, which restricts us having a good lake swim, a great blue heron, a lake Christmas tree platform provides a great sunbathing platform. Now we have four of them, the endangered Pleiada woodpecker and the disturbing armadillo. The small boat sailors have some good, bad days, but also many, many good days. Radio-controlled sailboat sailing is treasured activity for some. In 1990, the developers were approached about creating a Class A motorhome section only. 30 lots in the vistas were set aside, and later 55 lots in what is known as the Horizons at the east end of the resort were included. The lake of 60 acres ranges in depth from about 15 to 17 feet in the West Lake and up to 22 to 25 feet in the East Lake. An abundant supply of grass carp and an excellent weed control contractor has greatly improved the shoreline in recent years. With the end of each day, a sense of fulfillment is felt by all. Originally, the developer purchased an off-site location for the wastewater treatment plant in order to not have the sewer plant directly in the resort. Later, a hookup to the Collier County sewer system was achieved. Early on, the amenities were developed. The Chicky Hut, known as a Chicky, built by Seminole Indians, was one of the first. These structures, by state law, can only be rebuilt or refurbished by Indians of the Seminole tribe. This caused rebuilding costs to be prohibitive to replacement, and concern developed over the fire hazard, especially when flame-throwing Tahitian dancers were invited in to perform. Then everyone waited for that special structure. The main clubhouse. Concrete block walls and wood roof trusses is typical of Florida construction. One of the first dinners, potluck style, which was a standard back then on concrete floors. Many renovations have occurred in this place we are today. New sound control panels were installed. The parquet floor has remained in the center of the room. Space was increased to provide for an expanded kitchen. Social recreation and the impression at the entrance provided a new look. Hurricane shutter, window coverings, and upgraded stage area for entertainment were additional new features. New energy efficient dimmable lights were added. A first-class full-size commercial kitchen was a real plus, adding much to our lunch and dinner enjoyment. A rejuvenated workout room has increased participation 2- and 3-fold. The game of pool competition is making a rebound this season in this excellent, well-lit room. Not only inside, but outside the original clubhouse, pictured was painted and transformed with a new metal roof. Plantings of shrubbery and flowers were added. Second to the clubhouse, swimming pools ranked very high, along with hot tubs to relax those weary muscles. Recently, the pools and hot tubs were converted to soft water pools, sanitized without the use of harsh liquid chlorine chemicals, for a softer skin feeling and longer lasting swimsuits, along with less damage to the operating equipment. Under the American Disabilities Act, two lifts were added. I don't know what each of you have experienced, but this pool, hot tubs, insect-free covering is a signature amenity here. Phase one and the center of activity is shown with its four cul-de-sacs, was completed in 1893. Crystal Lake Phase one was developed with 20-foot by 60-foot concrete, light posts, two short queen palms, and a picnic table. But without the grass and roadway, conditions remain quite barren. The addition of the small queen palm trees was an improvement. If desired, sheds up to 100 square feet could be purchased from the developer and placed on the lot. These sheds were outfitted with many of the items found in a home, including washer, dryers, showers, and lavatories. Expanding the concrete or pavers to 30 feet wide and 70 feet long at owner expense was allowed, leaving 2 5-foot easements on each side of the lot and a 20-foot vehicle parking easement in front. Park models were sold by the developers in phase one, which consisted of one mobile unit and building a Florida room with vinyl windows. The vistas and part of the horizons remains a Class A restricted area and will remain that way for another 10 years. 8 shuffleboard courts remain in use today in excellent condition. Last month, in fact, the courts were resurfaced to bring them back to near original condition. The game played by both men and women provides a relaxing, fun time. Equipment is available to be used if you left yours at home. Good nighttime lighting is also available for after dark play. Although horseshoes have been reduced in its level of activity, the pits have been reconstructed for excellent play. In 2012, the lake water irrigation system was revamped to provide for one pumping station instead of 3. The original water plant was removed after direct connection to Collier County water system was completed to make room for the new administration building, replacing the temporary double-wide trailer on lot 4001. The change to using lake water for irrigation rather than Collier County water greatly reduced costs. The cost of this changeover was paid for by an assessment of the owners, which returned great savings in the long run and continues the savings today. Built with contractors and some volunteers at a cost of just over $400,000. Again, the block construction for termite protection and hurricane resistance was a part of the project. The completing building provided space for the administrative staff, a well-equipped library available to everyone, offices for the rental and sales department. The head end of our own cable system started in 2008, and 2 activity rooms used for Wii bowling, ladies and men's poker, and internet availability and other activities. In 2008, new cable and optic fiber cable were laid throughout the resort, providing upgraded cable TV and internet service to every lot. The cost of this project was borne by an assessment to the owners, which resulted in reduced maintenance fee costs, which provided a payback in less than 3 years. Early on, there was a need for a cooker to take care of those large lunch and dinner functions, and once again, volunteers were called upon to make it happen. It is one of a kind and continues to be used today. Another need was to have our own mail room and mail distribution center. Volunteers assembled under the banner of Al and Al Construction, made up of Al Cameron and Al Jodwin, and an excellent user facility was completed. Crystal Lake is a single drop location for postal service. The mail is received from the rural route carrier, and our employee sorts and distributes the mail to the boxes for pickup by the residents. Always with an eye to bettering and enhancing Crystal Lake, a sturdy, stately, well-lit 3-lane bridge now stands where the small 2-lane nondescript span stood before. The new bridge of 2 lanes that was to be provided by Southwest Florida Water Management District was expanded and enhanced by the Crystal Lake Property Owners Association to make a 3-lane bridge with pillars and lights. Unlike many other communities in Collier County, because of the middle school across the road, we are blessed with a traffic light allowing resort residents to exit safely north and south, right or left, with caution always with a green light for those on Collier Boulevard who are distracted by observing the changing light. As you can see, many workers and many days are required to complete the structure. Working day and night, the bridge was completed in the fall for the season and beyond. If you look around Collier County, there are not many communities requiring a bridge over the canals that are three lanes for the residents' convenience. The management and board of directors at the time are congratulated for their foresight and leadership. A dedication and a lunch was provided by Southwest Florida Water Management District. Please note the number of residents in attendance before the free lunch in early October. When the park was completed, a large piece of land on the northeast side was the site of a sewer treatment plant. When connection was made to Collier County's sewer system, the land was set aside for open storage lots. In 1998, the first of six enclosed buildings was constructed and put in service. For the individual owner's payment of the cost of each building space, they were provided a 20-year lease at a very reduced lease payment to provide the return on their investment. The storage and lease fees provide well over $100,000 to the POA, which have helped to hold the resort maintenance fees in check. In building 4, a 40-by-50 room was developed for a large variety of activities, including stained glass, workshops, scrapbooking, fused glass, painting classes, and table tennis. A recent development is a pickleball north of the building 6 in the storage area. A few years ago, a new group of volunteers came to be known as the Junkies, retrieving and recycling cast-off objects from resort residents to be resold or extracted the metals. The money obtained is returned in the form of donation inside and out of the resort. The small clubhouse built in phase 3 was recently redecorated, providing activity space for yoga, bridge, talk, and small social gatherings with full bathroom and laundry facilities and a small kitchen. A second pool and spa provide a relaxing environment for residents. Bocce ball has become a popular sporting and social activity for many residents, with two courts being finished. Recently, the board of directors have approved the addition of shade courts at each end to be completed this winter. Discussions are pending the expansion and redevelopment of additional pickleball courts due to the increased interest exhibited over the last couple years. In addition, there's a growing interest in kayaking on the lake. There have been requests for some launching facilities at the boat dock, with the only drawback availability of funding. As Collier County developed Collier Boulevard from a two-lane road to a six-lane road plus turn lanes, rather than another concrete fence, a berm was built and chain-link fence installed and vegetated to mitigate the noise from Collier Boulevard. One of the original amenities, the tennis courts, were recently refurbished with new surfaces equal to hard-true clay courts found only at exclusive tennis clubs. The cost was shared by the tennis players, who provided about $22,000 of the $65,000 cost. In the year 2000, a memorial committee was formed. A fund was developed in memory of our neighbors who had passed, which was used to design and build a beautifully landscaped entrance fountain. The fund continues today to maintain this memorial of those honored each year, and memorial services held to remember those who have passed in the previous year. Perhaps the most important part of our resort, the glue that holds everything together, are the leaders who have fought and strived to keep Crystal Lake special, and many, many volunteers who have run the dinners, the social activities, the events, sports, classes, crafts, games, and meetings. As the sun rises over Crystal Lake, we are looking forward to the next 25 years. Who knows what will be enhanced? More pickleball courts, more kayaking, more gardens, but one thing is for certain. The owners and renters will work hard to accommodate the people in order to keep Crystal Lake simply the very best.